Hello and assalamu alaikum. I hope that all of my students will be doing great. This is lecture number 3 of the course Renewable and Alternative Energy Systems, and I am your course instructor Usman Javed. So in this lecture we will discuss about energy units, which are barrels, gallons and tons. We will discuss about their units. Also, we will briefly discuss about the British thermal units, BTU, and the British thermal units, BTU content of various fuel sources, which might include coal, natural gas, and furnace oil, etc. At the end, we will do an example in which BTU conversion is necessary. So let's start. So first of all, let us discuss about energy units. The first one and the most important one is the barrel. The unit of volume for crude oil and petroleum products. One barrel is equivalent to 42 gallons. Initially, when the barrel was formed, it was a kind of drum. If the barrel exceeded 42 gallons, it was quite heavy for the field workers to lift a barrel, and if the barrel was less than 42 gallons, then it was not profitable for the petroleum transporters to transport a barrel. The transportation cost was increased, so it was standardized that one barrel should be equivalent to 42 gallons, and now it has become a convention. One barrel is also equal to 35 imperial gallons or UK gallons, and one barrel is also equivalent to 9702 cubic or 5.6 cubic feet. On the second comes the gallon. Gallon is the measure of volume, and it is primarily used in United States. In Pakistan, we measure in liters. One US gallon is equivalent to 3.785 liters or 231 cubic inches. There are 4 quarts in 1 gallon, 2 points in 1 quart, and 16 US fluid ounces in a pint. In 1 US gallon, these are the length, width and height of fluid ounces, equivalent to 128 fluid ounces, 4 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 16. That will result in the total volume. Volume is equivalent to length multiplied by width multiplied by height. Next come the tons. Short ton or US ton is equal to 907.185 kilogram. Long ton or UK ton is 1016.05 kilogram and metric ton or ton is equivalent to 1000 kilograms. Now comes the most widely used term BTU, British Thermal Unit. It is actually a measure of heat content of energy resources. In chemistry, you have studied about specific heat of water, that is the amount of energy to increase the temperature of water by 1 degree. BTU standardizes the quantity of the heat that is required to rise the temperature of 1 pound of liquid by 1 degree Fahrenheit. They have specified the word pound and not the mass, pound. It means that they have specified it in mass and not the volume, because the volume of the liquids including water tends to change with respect to increase or decrease in temperature. This is an example of US Energy Information Administration collects data on volume or weight of energy resources produced, imported or exported or consumed, and converts this information into British thermal units equivalents for their comparison. The second energy unit is the barrel of oil equivalent. It is the way of standardizing energy sources to energy in one barrel. For example, one barrel of crude oil has the capacity of the same energy content as about 6000 cubic feet of natural gas. So this quality of quantity of natural gas is considered to be equivalent to one barrel of oil. The next unit is the million tons for oil of oil equivalent. Million ton of oil equivalent is the amount of energy that is released when we burn 1 million or 1 megaton of crude oil. Similarly, tons of coal equivalent is the amount of energy that is associated when we burn 1 ton of coal. This energy is also equivalent to the energy obtained from burning 5.2 barrels of oil or 890 cubic meters of natural gas. Then comes the terajoules. Mega, giga and tera. These are standardized units of the powers of 10. Mega means 10 raised to power 6. Giga means 10 raised to power 12. Tera means 10 raised to power 12. terawatt hours means 10 raised to power 12 watt hour, or if we convert it into kilowatt, then 10 raised to power minus 3 is kilo, so 9 plus 3 equals 12. So these two are equivalent. So this whole information needs not to be remembered. The tables are already available and you might use them at your will. These are the conversions of BTU content for various fuels, and we are gonna use this table in our next two examples. So 1 barrel of United States produced crude oil is 572200 BTU. Similarly, 1 gallon of finished motor gasoline is 120429 BTU. 1 gallon of diesel fuel is 137381 BTU. 1 gallon of heating oil is equal to 138500 BTU. 1 barrel of residual fuel oil is equal to 628700 BTU, and similarly the remaining. I would suggest you to write down this table on your notes so that you might be able to perform the next two examples easily. This is example number 1A, and it is related to your course learning outcome number 1 based on cognitive level 2 of your Bloom's taxonomy and program learning outcome number 1. In this example, we have to identify the home which consumed more energy for its heating needs in past winter. There are two houses, house A and house B. And in this example, the house A uses natural gas furnace and it used 81,300 cubic feet of natural gas during last winters for fulfilling its heating purposes or heating requirements. On the other hand, the house B has a furnace which burns heating oil instead of natural gas, and the house B used 584 gallons of heating oil in the last winter. So considering the table that was shown in the previous slide, we can find that 1 cubic foot of natural gas is equivalent to 1037 BTU, British thermal units. So for the usage of house A, they have used 81,300 cubic feet. So we multiply 81,300 cubic feet to converted British thermal units, and 81,300 multiplied by 1037, the usage of house A will be converted into British thermal units, and that is equivalent to 84,308.100 BTU. Now, from the conversion chart or from the table, 1 gallon of heating oil is equivalent to 138,500 British thermal units. So, for calculating the BTUs of house B, which uses furnace that burns heating oil instead of natural gas, we multiply the number of gallons with their equivalent BTUs, that is 584 gallons multiplied by 138,500, and the house B energy consumption converted into BTUs is 80,884,000. So by sheer comparison, we can observe and identify the home which consumed more energy for its heating needs. The house A, that is 84,308,100 BTU, and the house B usage is 80,884,000 BTU. So comparing these usages by house A and house B, we can conclude that the house A consumed more energy as compared to house B. This is the continuation of example 1. And it is its part B. It is also based on program learning outcome number 1, cognitive level 2, and course learning outcome 1. And here we want to compare the price of fuels for heating house A and house B on an equal basis. Natural gas cost $10.98 per 1000 cubic feet, and the heating oil cost $2.96 per gallon. Now we have to identify that which option among the natural gas and the heating oil is cheaper option between two fuels by the comparison of their prices, that are $10.98 per cubic feet, that is of natural gas, and $2.96 per gallon, that is the cost of the heating oil. So again we see the conversion chart that 1 cubic foot of natural gas is 1037 BTUs. So it means that 1000 cubic feet of natural gas will be equal to 1037 multiplied by 1000. So we added 3 zeros is equal to at the end. We converted for 1000 cubic feet because the price that is mentioned in the question statement gives the cost of 1000 cubic feet. So 1000 cubic feet of natural gas is equivalent to this 1037000 BTU or 1.037 mega BTU. Mega means 10 raised to power positive 6. So if we move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1.037, that is 1.037 mega BTU. So the cost of natural gas per million BTU is 10.98,000 per cubic feet divided by 1.037, that is $10.59. Now we will calculate for 1 gallon of heating oil, that is seen from the conversion chart, that is 1.38500 BTU, or if we convert into 10 raised to power plus 6 mega BTU, million BTU, so 1.235 MBTU. So the cost of the heating oil per million BTU is 2.96 dollars divided by 0.1385, that is 21.37. so by comparison of 10.59 and 21.37, that are the costs of natural gas and the heating oil per million BTU, it can be concluded that natural gas is 2 times cheaper than the heating oil.